got it on smash. Put on the gas, I will not crash. Honey, y'all dash, honey, y'all dash, honey, y'all dash, honey, y'all dash, honey, y'all dash.
They slept on the team that they owe me. I need a ring and a trophy. I say I'm the best cause I am. It's noted in keeping it low key. I can carve up the D like a turkey. I run straight through the D like a train.
Welcome in, everybody. It's the coach. This is Madden 20 on EA Sports. Ahead, we'll see the NFL's all-time passing leader, Drew Brees, and the New Orleans Saints as they match up with Jameis Winston and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. I'll be back with you again with scores around the league at halftime. But kickoff right around the corner. And standing by to call the action, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
We are just a few miles from the Gulf Coast of Florida at Raymond James Stadium here in Tampa. With the echoes of cannon blast still ringing in our ears from the north end zone, the Bucs were introduced a moment ago, and they are all set as their guys will do battle with Drew Brees and the New Orleans Saints. Hi again, everyone. Brandon Gordon alongside Charles Davis. And Charles, you take a look at this Buccaneer ball club. They were losers last time out, but winners of 7 of 9 prior to that. Meanwhile, for the visiting Saints, they come off a disappointment last time out that put an end to their modest 3-game win streak. Season has hit high gear, and off we go in week 11 on EA Sports. This is taken at his 4. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The Saints getting set to take over, and they will be led out by the all-time leading passer in NFL history in his 19th year now in the NFL, Drew Brees. On play action, it's Brees. Caught here by Griffin. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates.
That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Now Brees, and that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
It is tough to complete pass against zone defenses. The windows that you see open, they shrink pretty rapidly. How about being able to hit a moving target against a zone before the next guy can get there and make a play on the ball?
Not easy for any quarterback, no matter the situation. And there, the defense won the battle. They forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
And going to the air on the opening drive. That's to his running back, complete. So first possession, fourth and short. Field goal's no gimme from here. You think about going for it?
I'm not just thinking about it. I'm signaling, go for it. Let's get this, all okay. Right? Yeah, look, you're right. You know, the field goal's there, but it's not a chip shot. My big thing is opening drive, you're trying to establish momentum. Let's not stall it ourselves. Let's go get this first down and then continue on downfield and try and get a touchdown.
I like your confidence.
Why not? Let's go.
The Buccaneers heading out. It's the fifth-year man, Jameis Winston, in charge. And the big key for Jameis this year, he's finding a way to avoid those turnovers. They've been his undoing during his tenure in Tampa. It's no secret. 14 interceptions again last year, plus 7 fumbles in just 9 games played. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8. The numbers on the ground for Jones last week, 18 carries, 106 yardage-wise, and the score as well.
And the way they ran the ball in last week's game has to be satisfying to their entire staff, because they're seeing not just a back gain big yardage, but they're seeing an offensive line really in sync.
They'll try and run for it with Jones, and he's going to have the first down at about the 38. It's a first down following a gain of three. That right there, a good sign for a team that's had trouble converting third down so far this year. They're in the bottom five in the NFL, but they come through there.
Yeah, and I bet if we put our guy Marvin on the case and say, Marvin, tell us where they rank on third and what, right? I bet they're in the top five in the league on third and five, third and six, third and seven or more, because that's how you end up not converting. Just too much yardage to pick up on third down.
They'll run with a former Tar Heel, T.J. Logan, and he'll get it down to the 47 here. 7 yards there and a first down.
I know what you're thinking out there. I know a lot of you are thinking, take a shot downfield. It's a great spot for it. I'd say maybe later in the game, definitely in the second half. Right now, I think they're just trying to get some momentum built. Get a first down, pick it up, and keep moving.
It's a gain of 16, first down Tampa Bay. Jameis now on first down. He finds his target. It's Evans. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That's good for a Buccaneer first, a pickup of 12 yards. And that's the first connection. The number one overall pick in 2015 finding the number seven pick in 2014 in Evans.
And what a great target Mike Evans is for Jameis Winston. Winston's a pretty accurate thrower, but that catch radius that Evans provides, that makes him that much more dangerous.
They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. Working out of the gun, Winston. The quick slant caught. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. From the 2 now, second and goal. Jameis to throw it. Godwin's got it. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Chris Godwin, his second touchdown on the season. And the Bucs have taken the lead. So now a 2-point conversion attempt coming for Winston and the Bucs. From the gun, Winston. And he slings one that's incomplete. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a 2-point conversion, all that exit, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
They run with a former Viking and Raider. It's Latavius Murray. And this will go as a gain of 7 as he gets it to the 30-yard line. 6-3 is our score after one. It's the NFL on EA Sports. On play action. Now Breeze. And it's hauled in by Jared Cook.
Jared Cook is a guy who's been around the NFL. He's been with the Titans, the Rams, the Packers, and the last 2 years in Oakland. Now he makes a move to the Big Easy, where he pairs with Drew Brees and forms a nice little threat.
And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Now a play fake. Brees. Caught the tight end Hill, and this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 25-yard line. On first and 10, here's Breeze. Oh, he can't hang on. That was a dream chance for any D lineman to possibly get a pick, but instead it falls down incomplete. To throw once more on second and 10. Breeze looking again for Thomas, this time complete. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs' 13-yard line. You on first down. Murray. And this play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back to the 15. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down. Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Here's Murray. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down. The last two plays each lose a yard. They'll try to move forward here on third and 12. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. Crabtree has it, and he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Michael Crabtree, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And once again, the Saints are back out in front. Lutz good on the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. That time, a 9-play drive, and it ends with a touchdown for New Orleans. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. This one taken just inside the 10. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. A reminder that coming up later tonight, a good one on Sunday Night Football. We'll see what could have been a playoff matchup a season ago. The Bears and the Rams from L.A. And then tomorrow night, Monday Night Football from down in Mexico. Mexico City, to be precise. The Chiefs and the Chargers going at it. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Ronald Jones, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Buccaneers have once again taken the lead. Now here's Winston as his guys will line up and go for the two-point conversion. Winston looking end zone, but it's incomplete. So now, Charles, two touchdowns, two tries at two-point conversions, and both fail.
And you want to say, let's go ahead and run the kicker out there from now on. But the problem is you're chasing points at this stage. So now you've got to dial up more two-point conversions and hope you're successful from here on out.
Drew Brees getting ready to go again on offense. Been a decent start for him here in this first half, but bottom line, his team's losing. They got to fix something.
And it starts with him. He has to keep that little quarterback strut going right now to make sure that his team sees him as confident. Continue to try and up his game, but just let them know, hey, if I'm around, if I'm the one calling signals and throwing the football, just follow me, we'll get there. Sometimes that will do more to elevate a team than anything else.
See if he has that confidence. Now Breeze. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Throwing now is Breeze. Complete. Smith has it. Able to push his way through.
Personal foul. Unnecessary roughness. Defense.
I know it's an emotional game, Charles. You can't do that.
And when you get into your film sessions and you argue your case with your coaches, that's exactly what they say at the end. You just can't do it. It costs your team.
They go play action here on first down. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Andrew Adams. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And, you know, certainly a lot of football left to be played. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're first place in their division. Looking good, looking to be a threat come January.
And let's think about what every team has in their goals, all right? Number one goal is what? Make the playoffs. Number two goal is win your division. Number three goal, and the biggest goal, I think, is to be the highest seed possible that you can be heading into the playoffs so that you can have as many home games as possible to try and get you to the Super Bowl.
And right now, fighting for everyone possible to try to at least secure home field for the wild card and or divisional round. That's good for a Buccaneer first, a pickup of 12 yards. Now a first down carry by Jones. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags.
Defense.
So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask.
any part of it, that's going to be 15 yards.
After the penalty, it's Jones. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That's good for a Buccaneer first, a pickup of 12 yards.
Only one way to describe Ronald Jones' rookie season with Tampa Bay, and that's disappointing. Drafted to be their lead runner, just 23 carries on a team that ranked 29th in the NFL in rushing.
David Onyemata there on the tackle. Throwing on second down, Winston, and this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. They come up to the line now facing a third and 10 after the incompletion. From the shotgun, it's Winston. Looking for Perriman there, he's got him. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one. The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. They'll go with Jones. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Ronald Jones, as the first half is winding down, as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that makes this a 9-point game. So the drive there took six plays. And it's Ronald Jones that polishes it off with a touchdown run. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. But we're under 20 seconds to go in the half. I'm guessing the wise play here is be safe.
That is the wise play because if you think about trying to fool them here, here's what you're facing. You're facing a loosened up secondary, playing a lot deeper than normal. So even if you run some type of misdirection, you're only going to fool them for a second or so. And guess what? They're so deep, they're really not going to be out of position. Take the knee, get to the locker room.
This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone.
Come on now, let's go.
So here are the Bucs to take over on offense. They lost two straight coming in, but good news for them right now. They've got the lead and the football. The second half starts with a carry by Jones. And he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27. Tackle there by Alex Anzalone. They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. He'll have a first down past the 40 and all the way up to the 46.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 15 yards as Tampa Bay picks up the first. So in Saints territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 39-yard line. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. First down Tampa Bay there, a gain of 13.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. First down, Winston. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of four.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done.
This has been a good drive so far, and it's been a running game for the most part that's powered them down there. Another nice burst there, picking up a first down. Now it's first and 10, as you said, in the red zone.
Money! You ain't going nowhere.
Back to the ground, this time with Jones. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Ronald Jones, his third touchdown of the game, his eighth on the year, as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit. And this is going to be intercepted. It's the linebacker, Alex Anzalone.
Well, as most teams do in their two-point attempt, they pass the ball. Instead, it gets intercepted. And remember, if you pick it off, you got a chance to take it all the way back, get 2 points yourself, right?
Yeah, not the case here. That's why you got to be really careful with those throws, especially to the outside. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of
the
second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use. Just something to get you off to a quick start.
Now a play fake here on first down. Throw left side complete. It's Murray. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 17 there and a New Orleans first down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field. We've got
this. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
Ready, you kill. First
down, New Orleans. Into the red zone, it's Breeze. And brought in by the tight end, Cook. Give him a couple on the catch, it's second and 8.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Looking to throw again on second down. Breeze, that's caught. It's Thomas. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Breeze on the hook up to Thomas for the New Orleans first. They'll try to run it in with Murray. And he takes it across and into the end zone. Touchdown, Saints. Latavius Murray, his 5th touchdown now on the year. As they're now just an extra point away from getting back within one score.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you've got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. They'll start out on the ground with Jones. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. Back now in Tampa. It's the Bucs. They've got the football. They also are in front here on the scoreboard as we start the 4th. On 2nd and 7, Winston. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. It's the linebacker, Alex Anzalone. Drew Brees, 6 fourth quarter comebacks a season ago, and that led the NFL. He'll try to deliver another one. So after the INT, it's Brees. Gets this to a standout receiver, Thomas. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. 17 there and a New Orleans first down. Brees now 13 out of 17 throwing the ball. He's got a first down. They run from the shotgun with Murray. He'll get it inside the red zone, but only for a couple down to the 19. The last run got a couple here, 2nd and 8. They go with Murray again. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. Well, when you're leading in the 4th quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all, and now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
Following the penalty, it's Murray. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. Yikes, a four-yard loss really sets him back now for second down. It's second and goal, back to the eight-yard line now. Washington now out of the gun. And he'll be stopped just outside the five at the six. Only a yard there, and that'll bring us to third and goal. Under four to play now. Clock running, third down. Bree's going to throw. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by the rookie linebacker from LSU, Devin White. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. 20. 10. And it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for Buccaneer TD. Now remember, this is the number one defense in the National Football League. There's a good example of why.
Shows that they set an aggressive tone, not just stopping the run, not just getting after the quarterback, but the ball's in the air. They treat it like they're the receivers, and they went after that one and took it all the way.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And following the pick six, and they had decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this run.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete. From the gun on third down, Breeze. And he finds Cook. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. It goes as a gain of eight, and it moves the chains. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Again, it's Breeze. And this one complete to Smith. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It'll be a Saints first down on a pickup of 13. So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Now, Breeze again. Got an open man, it's Washington. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Down under 2 minutes to go in this football game. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Throwing again on second down, Breeze. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Breeze now to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Murray. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of two. To throw again on second down, Breeze. Throw left side, complete. It's Murray.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They've become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays.
And this is caught now for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively, though, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like,
Yeah,
you know.
Doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
On first down, Jones. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. The first down run got five. Here's second and five. Again, it's Jones. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two. as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game. After the run by Jones, here's first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2. Now the Saints will use their third and final timeout as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. This, in all probability, another run here on 2nd and 8. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. It's 1st and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. Now Jones. And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it. Trying to bust out of that losing funk, and these fans have to like this. And all right, fellas, this is more like it.
And I know that if this holds up after the game, they're going to give the fans a lot of the credit being at home, getting the support. But you and I both know it goes deeper than that. They had to get it together in their own facility, look each other in the eye and say, okay, what's it going to take to break this losing streak? And they really came together with a good week of practice.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. So Breeze and the Saints down by 15. A little over 30 seconds remaining. It's an extremely tall order in front of them, but they've got the ball with a first down. On first down, Breeze. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in. An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. To throw, it's Breeze. Got it complete to Crabtree. He's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. To throw, it's Breeze. Rush coming, and he's taken down. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on 4th down. They're going for it. Charles, we saw a lot of points go up in this one. Certainly defensively, stuff that they can look at on film, don't you think?
No doubt about it. And they've got to go back and check where the errors are, how they're going to fix them, and continue to get better at what they do. But they also need a little adjustment with their confidence. To give up that many points, even if you win a game, that can hurt you.
Asking my name, huh?
You ready?
S-T-R-O, I ain't come to play with you.
Yeah.
Life challenging, but I wouldn't trade with you.
Trade.
It's early, I'm up.
Yeah.
I can't spend the day with you. I'm out in my business. I ain't getting paid with you.
Nope.
My color bright.
Yeah.
I ain't finna play with you. Man, I gotta come clean like
I
made with you. I've been on my everybody drop when I drop.
Yeah.
Look at shorty, she support, bruh. Lifting up. Never not on my grind. New York City time. Another brother better, you will never find. I've been in my bag like groceries. Competition shouldn't take shots, take notes, please. Reporting live from the winner's side. Ready try, keep a different vibe. Is you down the ride, never tie. You will never know, you ain't never tried. Work it out, hit the gym, hit the field. Hey, yo, I need that. Big chips, man, I need that. Hustle hard on the job, you can see that. On my head is real good, we don't need your feedback. They clear the way with my crew coming through. What I do? Lace up the shoes, chase double rings. What I do? Lace up the shoes, chase double rings.
Now what I do?
Lace up the shoes, chase double rings.
Yeah.
Beats, leave it in the street, chase on the news.
What I do? Lace up my shoes, chase W's. Great colored coupes, oh no, no, I can't be number 2. MVP the league, most valuable, they sweet as apple juice. Talking trophies, I didn't grab the few, can't match this attitude. I wear my heart on my sleeve, please. I move like the wind, can't catch this breeze, freeze. Stop you in your tracks, there's not no preseason. We seeking W's like Tupac used to throw up. Forget it, might as well forfeit, your team shouldn't even show up. What you wanna be when you grow up? They used to ask me. Naturally, I chose an athlete. Competition never matched me. We ain't go together like camouflage and polka dots. Focus on your position, just know your spot. Sure, don't stop, it's a long season. They planning on winning for the wrong reasons. Trying to get my number retired, can't let these frauds beat us. I figured out the recipe. Never let opponents get the best of me. I'm focused on my legacy.
Big chips, man, I need that. Hustle hard on the job, you can see that. On my head is real good, we don't need your feedback. They clear the way with my crew coming through. What I do? Lace up the shoes, chase W's.
What I do?
Lace up the shoes, chase W's.
Now what I do?
Lace up the shoes, chase W's.
Yeah.
Beats, leave it in the street, case on the news.
It's lonely on top of the throne. I am a king, not a pawn. Hop on a jet, cross the gold. I guess the world is my home, and there's so many miracles burning my dome, and like turbulent air, I'm switching these flows. If you look at my neck, boy, I'm letting it snow. I'm sturdy as hell, you're Sylvester Stallone. They showing me love in my city. Yeah, you saying hippies. Women like Nicki know what I'm about. I'm not. The stereotypes, they do not fit me. I'm bigger than life. Give everyone jaws. I'm not a guard, but part of the squad. I'm playing my part, but I'm LeBron. We should the team, I feel Jackson at heart. The homie calling from a cell. A couple of homies be making it. Making it. I just want all of them dudes to do well. Not worry about taking a couple of L's. Don't sin for me, just win for me. Don't kill for me, just live for me. Keep it real for me. We eat together, leave the bill for me. Like,
hand on my heart. I give it all I got. Walk the walk inside the talk. Take it higher, that's a God. Hand on my heart. No, I give it all I got. Walk the walk, talk the talk. Take it higher, that's a God. Never stopping, that's a must. Always winning, never lost.
Hey, everybody, it's the coach. This is the
Coach, the weather this time of year in the South, perfect. Fall football weather, and we've got the roof wide open here at Mercedes-Benz Stadium in the heart of Georgia. Today, it's week 12 of the NFL season, and we've got a good one in store between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Atlanta Falcons. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line.
You ready?
Squeeze, double, double.
Shit.
Here's the second year back from Southern Miss, Ito Smith. And he'll get this from the 25 to the 30 for a pickup of 5.
And the judge does a nice job there of navigating and picking up some yardage. Remember, no Tevin Coleman in the backfield, so he's moved up in the pecking order, getting a lot of playing time for these Atlanta Falcons.
And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this as this game progresses, because when you can have that type of a game in the middle of the defense, it hurts them in so many ways, because most teams like to be strong down the middle. And if you can sting them there, that'll open things up for you on the outside as well.
That's where he, their big tight end, is so good, that middle third, the seam routes, the in routes. Yeah, you're right. Probably see more of that.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage and fortitude to go in the middle as well, and he's got it.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you go make a play on the football.
And this time he's going backwards. So after the no gain on the last attempt, here they get him behind the line. Third down, Ryan. Oh, he almost picked it. Nearly a turnover there on their opening drive. That's a throw he'd like to have back. Now fourth down.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
Winston and the Bucks take over now, first and 10, just shy of the 30. Jones, and they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 15 yards as Tampa Bay picks up the first. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. This is Jones, and a good pickup there. He gets about 6 up to midfield. The numbers for Jones last week, the hat trick plus 1, 4 trips to the end zone with his legs.
And partner, you know how all the guys do when they do that little symbol now about eating, right? Keep feeding me. They just kept feeding him, and next thing you know, he kept getting in the end zone.
That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Let's go, baby.
Chris Godwin, the former Penn Stater, should see an increase in action and production in 2019. With Adam Humphries and DeSean Jackson gone from the team, 842 yards in 2018, second only to Mike Evans on the Buccaneers.
First down, Tampa Bay there, a gain of 13. A first down throw for Winston. That's complete to his receiver, Godwin. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8. Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. They'll run it here with Logan. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. And for the Falcons, 5 men in the secondary, now on 3rd. Winston, a handoff. This is Jones. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. Another good run there for a guy who, remember, on Wednesday was named NFC Offensive Player of the Week for what he did a week ago.
Yeah, and you know it takes some solid runs and some extra special ones in order to win that.
And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. T.J. Logan, his 1st touchdown on the year. As his guys are able to strike 1st here in this opening quarter. An ideal start for them, really. You force the punt, and then you go down and score.
And you've got to see a fist pump on the sideline from the head coach, don't you? Because he's turning to his bench, and he's telling his team, this is how we prepare. Force the punt, go downfield and score. I told you guys, it's just like a boxer in the gym preparing for the fight. Now we get to turn it all loose.
And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win 1st down. You win 2nd down. And guess what? You start accumulating 1st downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Ryan will bring the Falcons up now 1st and 10 at their 25-yard line. This is Quadri Allison, the rookie from Pitt. Space to maneuver at the 40. 23 yards on the pickup there and a 1st. This will probably be the last. Play of the quarter. Back now in Atlanta, 2nd quarter action. The Falcons with the football as they've got it with a 1st and 10. They'll throw on 1st down with Ryan. That's caught. It's Coleman. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on 2nd down. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the 1st down completion. On 2nd down, here's Smith. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42.
I can't help it. Every time I see Eric Berry make a play, as we just saw him make a tackle there, I just want to stand up and applaud.
Because he went to Tennessee like you?
Well, that doesn't hurt one bit, but how about the comeback? I mean, he came back from beating cancer and getting back to Pro Bowl level. One of the best players in the game.
14 yards there and a Falcon 1st down.
They're making it look easy out there. Another 1st down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. 4 plays, 3 1st downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. Carry for Smith, and he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Levante David in on the tackle. So a look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. And they tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in and playing at a high level. That's when you know you've drafted well, scouted free agents well, and stocked your team just the way you're supposed to.
It's 3rd and 7.
On 3rd down, Ryan. He's got Smith here. 14 yards there, and a Falcon 1st down.
And Ito Smith was a little bit of a surprise in 2018. Got unexpected playing time due to the absence of Devontae Freeman. Took full advantage of it. Had 27 catches out of the backfield last season. There's another one this year.
And he's not able to get away. Sacked back at the 22. Devin White in there to record the second sack of his young NFL career. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. That catch good for five. It's third down. They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. 8-0 our score with 2 minutes left in the second quarter. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. Now the Bucs going to use the first. First of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. Now Matt Bryant, who spent 4 seasons in a Buccaneer uniform. From the left hash, a chip shot here. Now the holder's going to keep it. He's going to try to run for it. They're not going to get it. They try to move the chains with a surprise, but it's a turnover on downs. They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work. And the Buccaneers defense holds, and they get the football back. They'll start the drive with a carry by Jones. And brought down, but not before reaching the 25. A big pickup there, 18 yards and a Buccaneer first. Now Jones. A gain of 3, second down.
What's the old expression, 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
7 yards there and a first down. Jameis now on first down. Open man is Howard, the tight end. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. That's a good chunk of yardage that's going to be canceled out.
And we always talk about hidden yardage in a game.
That's going to count as that because now it doesn't go on the books, but now they have to make that up again, don't they?
They're backed up here with a first and 20 now after the holding penalty. But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. So it can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Right, you know a coach said that, right? Yeah. Not an actual player, not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
And a pretty good run, all things considered. Probably would have liked that in the first quarter instead of right now as the clock continues to run. 5 men in the secondary now for the Falcons on third down. From the gun, Winston. That is caught. It's Perriman. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. They go play action here on first down. Looking downfield for Godwin. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. The intended target was Chris Godwin, but it's going to be second down. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. Jameis to throw it. There goes a deep ball in zone. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete. He was looking for Chris Godwin that time. And now it's third down. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Play action now. Winston. He's going to look deep for Perriman. And it's incomplete. Both players had a shot at that one. Neither can get it. And it brings up fourth down. The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. And they're out of timeouts, remember, so this is going to have to be a delay.
Offense.
And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. Fourth down, and the Bucs trot out the former 49er Bradley Pinion to punt it, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback. Final play of the first half, barring a penalty, as they come up on first and 10. And with time running short here, they'll simply take a knee, and that should do it for half number one. So one touchdown, 1 2-point conversion. That accounts for our first half total. 8-0 is our score. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much.
And just like that, on we head to half number two. The Bucs with a lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And they have been disruptive in the passing game, as we're going to see here.
And it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, you cover a guy in your area, and those windows that quarterbacks are seeking to throw into, they're closed in this case.
Yeah, they've been all over the place, knocking down pass after pass. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
Let's see if they do just that. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. 15 yards as Tampa Bay picks up the first. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Here's Jones. And a pretty good run there as he gets 7 down to the 33.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
Seven yards there at a first down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
Looking to throw on second down. Winston. And going to be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's third down. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they look to throw. And he's got a man. It's the tight end, Howard, complete. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Here's Winston. Godwin's got it. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Chris Godwin, his third touchdown now on the year as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit, get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, you know, the second half, no matter what, with his first 5 minutes, first 3, whatever, this was a big score to start the second half.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And their halftime hole now even deeper, and they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half.
Ryan hit, and he lost the football. And it's picked up by the Buccaneers.
With no running backs in the backfield to help pass protect, all the receivers in their patterns, it's going to be hot routes. If they sense a blitz or pressure on the quarterback, they've got to be prepared to break routes off early.
And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Ronald Jones hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Bucs capitalize on the short field as they take it in for 6. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Time here to remind you that coming up later tonight on Sunday Night Football, it's the Seahawks and the Eagles from Lincoln Financial Field in Philly. And then tomorrow night on Monday night, more birds with the Ravens involved in that one. Sadly, not taking on the Cardinals or Falcons, though. Instead, they'll match up with the Rams in L.A. The run there on first down, going to get them 5 up to the 30. Levante David, the Bucks' leading tackler, 6 of the last 7 years in there to make the stop. They'll run it again with Smith. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
Off the play fake. Here's Ryan. Looking downfield for Jones. Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. Picked off near the 29. And the return stops just a little bit shy of midfield at the 48-yard line.
Oh, and that's a nice job defensively to get a piece of the football. He's going to pop it into the air, and then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and pull in the interception.
Pretty good results here on the first down run as he takes this forward for about 6. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4. Play fake. Winston. He'll buy some time right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's 3rd down. Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. Working out of the gun, Winston. Looking downfield for into double coverage, and it's intercepted. It's Desmond Trufant. They needed a break. They needed to make a play here in the 3rd quarter. Defensively, they did that. Now they got to go quickly and get some points on the board.
And the best part is that they made their own break, taking the ball away. Now they just look at their offense and saying, guys,
let's go.
Come on, capitalize on this one.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now 2nd down. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a 2nd and 11. They go back to the ground with Smith. And just not much to be had there. 1 yard out to the 10. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Back now here on EA Sports. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number 4. To throw on 3rd down. Ryan. It's hauled in by Hardy. And he's going to be marked down short of the 1st down, right around the 17. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a 4th down. Here's Matt Bosher now, standing just outside his own goal line. This is fielded at the 27. A great return there, bobbing and weaving his way for 31 yards. And the Buccaneer offense will be set up well as they take over. They'll run on 1st down. Jones, and very little there. He might have gotten a yard. Yeah, I think he got a yard to the 41. They'll go again to Jones. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a 3rd and about 4. Winston from the gun on 3rd down. Looking for Perriman there. He's got him. And he's able to pick up the 1st down here before he goes down at the 26. Looking for Godwin, and he's got him complete. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. 7 yards to pick up on the pitch and catch. Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Winston, and he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. Winston to Godwin on the connection there for a Tampa Bay first. They'll throw again. Winston, and this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's 2nd down. They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's 2nd and goal now. This is Logan.
The
And, Brandon, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line. Because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines, as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
Third and goal, Winston. Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7. So they dial up the blitz on 3rd and inches. It pays off.
And frankly, they were probably dialing up a run blitz, expecting them to run it in that situation. But instead, they end up back at the quarterback and put him on the ground.
And that is intercepted by last year's NFL leader, DeMonte Casey.
So that's back-to-back drives where they're throwing an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. Now, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
Second down, a little more productive than first. 7 yards on the gain. It gets him to 3rd and 3 now. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Ryan, the open man is Smith. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well. Here's Ryan. Caught by Jones. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
Nice game there, partner, but you and I both know that won't do anything for the final score.
Let's go, baby.
Fourth down. Got it. By 25.
Now Ryan on first down. This complete to Jones. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. 17 yards and a first down for Atlanta. Here's Ryan to throw. That's going to be caught. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Falcons cut into that lead.
And that touchdown puts us in a position to have a discussion, doesn't it? Now, it'll be a 2-score game after the conversion.
Yeah, I mean, there's no doubt with a 2-score game, they're going to have to onside kick it. We'll just see if they've got a miracle up their sleeve.
And you wonder what onside kicks they're going to use and in what sequence if they hope to have a chance to win this game.
They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. So they come up on 2nd down. If they can get another run like we just saw, we'll likely put an end to this thing. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. The Falcons going to use the 2nd of their timeouts, as they'll get it with just a shade under a minute to go in the game. So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. They'll run it with Jones. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. You'd have to think likely another running play coming here, 2nd and 11. Again, this to Jones. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain that time, and it leaves them with 3rd and 11 coming up. I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?
I don't understand either why you would take any sort of a chance. We've seen it happen in the game of football. It doesn't matter whether you've watched high school, college, or the NFL. Some people get a little greedy, try to get that extra running play in, and it can backfire on them.
Open man is Godwin. It's complete. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages.
Ready. Flag. What is that? Green. Everything.
From the red zone now, Winston. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining. Good coverage that time by the linebacker, Deion Jones. It's now 2nd and 10. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Winston here to throw. And it's caught. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Chris Godwin with his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year, as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This is taken at the three.